talking about pumping lemma. So in the pumping lemma, there are three conditions are there. Those conditions, do you have the statements of pumping lemma? So let us I write the pumping lemma. L is regular. Suppose L is regular language. Then there exists a constant K such that depends on L such that for every x belongs to L, for every x belongs to L and the length of x is greater than or equal to k, we have UVW satisfying the following. UVW satisfying satisfying the following. The first one is UVW is equal to X concatenation of these three strings. UVW belongs to is equal to X, then length of UV is less than or equal to K, comma length of V is greater than or equal to zero, greater than zero, minimum one. And the third one is for all I I greater than or equal to zero, UV to the power of I W belongs to L. Okay, this is the statement of pumping lemma. In the previous class we have discussed. Okay, suppose L is regular, then there is a constant K such that K that depends on L, such that for every x belongs to L, the length of x is greater than or equal to K, we have U V W satisfying how it is satisfying these three conditions. UVW is equal to X means just we are dividing this string X into three substrings UVW, and the length of UV is less than or equal to K, and the minimum length of V is 1, minimum length because it is greater than 0, greater than 0 means minimum length is 1. Then for every I greater than or equal to 0, I greater than or equal to 0, UV to the power of IW belongs to L. So here what is K? K is the number of states that DFA accepts. This is a regular language, L is a regular, so there is a DFA, deterministic finite automata, which accepts the language L. So if it is a deterministic finite automata, then there is a number of states are finite, that is K. Okay, now we have considered a string X belongs to that regular language. How we are considering that string? The length of X is very large than number of states. It is possible because the infinite length string is also possible. Okay, so that's why it is then that string, whatever the considered string, you divide into three substrings UVW, and if you concatenate these UVW, that is equal to X. How you are dividing this big string into three? So this is U, this is up to this is U, this is U, and this is V, in between this is V and this is W. But if you add concatenate, this entire thing is total is X. Okay, and the length of UV is less than or equal to K, so it is, you have to take consider this string UV less than or equal to K, and minimum length this is 1, at least one character should be or alphabet should be here. So then for every I greater than or equal to 0, UV to the power of I, because the number of states are going to be repeat here, whatever the number of symbols are there, those many states are not going to be exist because of the length of x is greater than k. So some at least one state, at least two states are going to be repeat. So this is q and this is q. Okay. So then if you repeat this, you can repeat this string. That is for I greater than or equal to z. So this could be repeat any number of times. Then again you are at q state. Okay. So this is the lemma, pumping lemma. With this, based on this pumping lemma, we can prove that languages are not regular. For example, in the previous class, I have given a language that is a to the power of n, b to the power of n, such that n greater than or equal to 0. Okay, this is the language. Actually, we have seen in our earlier classes also, we have constructed a grammar, for we haven't constructed any finite automata, deterministic finite automata model, because this is not a regular. So by using pumping lemma, we can prove that whether a language is regular or not. Suppose if you have to show that this is not regular, is not regular, then what we have to do, by proof by contradiction, assume that this is regular. Regular, then we have to bring into a contradiction. So L is regular means then we have to, there is a DFA which consisting of k number of states, okay, k number of states. And consider an x is a string which is length is larger than k, then it is divided into three parts, u, v, w. Okay, this is divided into u, v, w. Actually, what is x? Consider from here, no, some a's are there, some b's are there. Okay, x is some a's are there, some b's are there. Let us consider x is equal to a to the power of k and b to the power of k. Okay, now what is the length of this x? 2k. Length of x is 2k because k plus k. So this is greater than k. 2k is greater than k. Okay. Now this is your x. X is a to the power of k and b to the power of k. So that means some a's, k a's, and k b's are there. How you have to consider uv is less than or equal to k. That means uv. So now this is has to be divided into three parts. Now uv w. So what is about uv? Uv is less than or equal to k means all uv is consisting of a's only. Uv is consisting of a's because of this condition, because of second condition, uv is less than or equal to k, and that means uv consisting of only a's. Okay, then length of v is greater than 0 means at least v is at least 1a. V is at least 1a. V is at least 1a. Then what is about the third condition? Third condition is, for every I greater than or equal to 0, uv to the power of I belongs to L. For example, I is equal to 0, then what it could be? Uw belongs to L. Uw belongs to L. For I is equal to 2, for I is equal to 2, then uvvw belongs to L. All these are contradictions. Uw does not belongs to L. Why uw does not belongs to L? Because at least v is 1a. Suppose k a's are there, k b's are there. You can remove some a's. How it is belongs to L? It is not belongs to L. Suppose u, v, v. So here at least one v. Then you can add some more a's. And of course, it is also does not belongs to L. Now this is a contradiction to pumping lemma. So actually, what is pumping lemma saying? That u, v to the power of I belongs to L. But in this particular case, a to the power of n, b to the power of n, u, v to the power of I does not belongs to L. So that means our assumption is wrong. What is our assumption? L is regular. Are you following now?
Yes, sir.
Are you getting or not? Should I explain once again?
Sir, explain once again.
Yeah. Any doubt for this pumping lemma? Pumping lemma. These three conditions are okay. Once if you can, yes, these sir. Conditions are satisfied, then I can go to the example. So
okay,
these conditions are okay for all of you. Everybody, yes, have understood and note down, make a note down. Okay. Now what we have to do, we have to prove L is equal to A to the power of N, B to the power of N, such that N greater than or equal to 0 is not a regular language. Okay. Proof by contradiction, what we are saying, L is regular. Okay. Suppose if it is L is regular, then there is a DFA consisting of how many states? K number of states. Okay. Then we have considered a string X. x from which language? A to the power of n, b to the power of n. So means in x, what is there? Equal a's and equal b's are there. So that x I am considering a to the power of k, b to the power of k. You can note down. You can note down on copy. Okay. Then what is the length of x now here? 2k. So here we have to assume length of x is greater than or equal to k. So here 2k. 2k is greater than k. Okay. Greater than or equal to k. Okay. Now what is our x now here? A to the power of k, b to the power of k. What is mean by this? A to the power of k, b to the power of k. K a's are there, k b's are there. Then this x, this is x actually. This is divided into three parts. How many parts? U, v, w. Okay. Now length of u, v, second condition, less than or equal to k. So length of u, v is less than or equal to k means u, v consisting of only s. U, v consisting of from here only s. It consisting of only s. And v greater than 0. So v means at least minimum 1a. Minimum 1a, 2a's or 3a's or any number of a's. It depends on division, your division. Okay. So this is about second condition. Up to this you have satisfied? Are you understood? Up to second point?
Yes, sir.
Now what is the first point? First point is uvw is equal to x. Now what is x here? What is x? X is equal to a to the power of k, b to the power of k, because we have to take this from this language only, L. Now this x is belongs to L because k a's are there, k b's are there, right? So then this x is divided into three parts, okay? U, v, w. Actually, what is u, v, w? It is consisting of a's and b's. But as per second condition, u, v is less than or equal to k. That means u, v consisting of only a's because less than or equal to k. So k means U starting, U has to be the first symbol of the string. So first symbol could be A. Okay. So that's why UV less than or equal to K means UV consisting of only S. And length of V is greater than 0 means V is at least 1A. Okay. So UV consisting of some number of A's and V must be at least 1A. 1A, 2A, 3A, any number of A's, maximum K A's. Right. Maximum K A's. Suppose if you consider u is equal to null string, then k is equal to v string, v is. Okay. Then for every i greater than or equal to 0, u v to the power of I belongs to L. So this is the third condition. Third condition is you could take I from either 0 or 1 or 2 or 3. For all those values, u v to the power of I belongs to L. For example, here I am taking I is equal to 0. For I is equal to 0, what it could be? This is null. This is for I is equal to 0, this is epsilon. Then UW belongs to L. UW belongs to L, actually, this condition. As per this condition, UW belongs to L. But in this particular case, UW does not belongs to L because equal A's and equal B's are there. You remove some A's. How it could be? For example, previously, 4 A's and 4 B's. 4 A's and 4 B's. And let us consider this is U. And this one symbol is V. So now this is rest of the string W. This is, you remove this V. Remove this V. Then if you remove this V, how many A's are there? Only 3 A's are there. But 4 B's, this does not belongs to L. As per this condition, it is belongs to L. Sometimes. Suppose I is 2. If I is 2 means one more extra A coming. One more extra A coming. 5 A's and 4 B's. This is also does not belong to L. This is a contradiction. Why it is having a contradiction? Because of this is regular. Because you have considered this is regular. So almost all the examples like this only. You have to get a contradiction. Proof by contradiction. First you have to assume that is regular language and you have to follow the procedure. You have to apply these three conditions. Then you are getting a contradiction. So contradiction means whatever our assumption is wrong. So what is our assumption? L is regular, so L is not. Okay, you can make a note down or a screenshot. Is it okay now? I understood.
Yes, sir.
What is the use of pumping lemma? Pumping lemma can state that whether it can verify a language is regular or not. If it is, these three conditions has to be satisfied if L is a regular. Yeah, our next topic could be non-deterministic finite automata. Non-deterministic finite image, NFA. As of now, I said this is we have discussed a deterministic finite automata. Now you have to understand what is the difference between now here finite automata is two types, DFA, NFA. As of now, we studied only DFA. Okay. But you don't know how what is the difference between NFA and DFA. We have studied only deterministic finite automata. Okay, that means deterministic finite automata means there is a state P and there is an input symbol A. We are going to Q state. Okay, so this delta function is defined P comma A is equal to Q. Of course, sigma is some alphabets. Sigma is something 0, 1 alphabet. Suppose if you change this delta function, okay? So what is the condition here in deterministic finite automata? Some particular state, particular input symbol, then you are going only one and only one state. Suppose if you change this property, that means on A, on the same A, if you go Q1 and Q2, this principle we can call it as a non-deterministic finite automata. Now I understood what is the difference between DFA and NFA. In DFA, as of now, one particular state, particular input symbol, we are going to one and only one state. Okay, this is about the delta function. This is about the delta function. Now if you change this delta function to delta dash, something P comma input symbol A and some set of states, why only two? It could be n number of states. Then this we can call it as a non-deterministic finite automata. Understood the difference between DFA and NFA? What is the difference between DFA and NFA? Are you getting?
Yes, sir.
Where is the difference?
Sir, in transition state, transition state delta.
Oh, only in transition, transaction function. Okay, yes. Only in a transition. Delta. Delta is defined from in this DFA, delta is defined from Q cross sigma to. Whereas in delta dash, defined from where to where? Q cross sigma to 2.
So 2 key power Q.
2 to the power of Q. Any subset of Q. Okay, this is the transition function is different. The rest of them are same. All the 5 tuples, DFA is a 5 tuples. NFA is also 5 tuples. Okay, DFA is 5 tuple, NFA is also 5 tuple. Right? Let us discuss this concept with an example so that you could understand. Now, first of all, I'm constructing NFA for a language. I'm not going to tell the language first. You can tell the language. I am constructing NFA first. Q naught is the initial state, and any 0 or 1 here itself on 1 0 going to Q1 state. You can note down. You note down on your copy. On 1, it is going to Q2 to state. And 0, 2, 3 state. Okay. And any zeros and ones? Okay. On 1, 2, 4. And one more 1, 2, 5. Any 0, 1? Why this is not DFA? Because on Q naught on 0, how many transitions are there? One is at Q naught, another one is at Q1. So that's why this is not determining. This is not a DFA because two transitions are there, Q naught on 0. Okay. Similarly, Q naught on 1, one is at Q naught, another one is at Q4. Here from Q1, on 1 only transition is there. For 0, there is no transition. Sometimes no transition is also exist in NFA. But whereas in DFA, definitely on all input symbols, transition must be there. But in NFA, it is not required. It is, if you want to transition, you take it. Otherwise, you omit it. You can remove. So that possibility is also there. Because pi, 2 to the power of mod q means pi. From that 0 onwards, there is no transition, null set, right? But this option is not there. Now, minimum in delta DFA, q cross sigma to q. Q cross sigma to q means definitely it has to move on all input symbols one state. But whereas in NFA, q cross sigma to 2 to the power of q, any subset of q, subset, one of the subset is pi also. Means there is no need to go for change a state on particular input symbol, right? You're getting now?
Yes, sir.
Yeah. Now, what is the? Can you tell me what is the language accepted by this machine NFA? X belongs to 0, 1 star.
Sir, this transition on Q4, this is missing, sir. You haven't written yet.
This is
on Q4, to Q5, yes, sir. So, sir, this is string having 0, 1, 0, or
11. Oh, x has substring either 010 or 11. X have a whole strings. X is a sentences over 01. But that's in that sentence as a substring, either 010 or 11. Okay, either 010 is a substring or 11 is a substring. Now let us construct, take an input 0110. Now we can construct how this model is working now. Now let us see how this model is going to be work. We can initially where that NFA, is at Q0 state. Initially, that NFA is Q0 state. Initially, the NFA is at Q0 state. Okay, Q0. On this input symbol, 0. Q0 on 0, how many transitions are there? Q0 on 0, one is at Q1. Another one is at Q0. So there are two possibilities, Q0 and Q1. Okay. This is computation tree, membership computation tree. Now, this is a membership means we are testing now 010 belongs to this language or not by using this model NFA. Now, next input symbol is 1. Okay. Next input symbol is 1. Q0 on 1, where it is Q0 on 1? 1 is at Q0, another one is at Q4. Now, this side, Q1 on 1, Q2. Okay. Now this is a computation tree. Now what is the next symbol? 1. Now Q1 on 1. This again it goes to Q2. Q4 1, it goes to Q5. Right, and Q2 1. So this is abort. There is no transition. Q2 1, there is no transition. Na? Means it stops. Okay. Then next input symbol is 0. Q2 0. It goes to Q3. Okay. Now Q5 0. Q5 itself. Okay. That's all.
Yes.
Now, what are the final states? Q3, Q5. Okay. Q3, Q5. Some mistake was there. Q5 on 0, Q5. Okay. Is it correct or made a mistake?
Sir?
Hmm.
Sir, after the second Q node, there is a Q node or Q1.
Something was, we made a mistake. Q0 on 1. Where we made a mistake?
Q node.
Here.
Yes, sir.
Q0 on 0, two states, no? Q0, 0, Q1. Okay, this is correct, no? Up to this is correct. Then next, 1 on 1, Q0 on 1, where you are going? Where you are going? Q0, Q4. Isn't it? Yes. This is okay, na? Now Q0 on 1, Q0 only. Q0, Q4. This one? This is Q4 again. Right? Like this? Yes. Shall I remove this and you have to tell if something is wrong, then you have to tell in the beginning only. Let us try from the beginning. Initially, where NFA Q0. What is the starting symbol? 0. Okay, Q0 on 0. What are the transitions? It can move Q0, Q1. Q0, Q1. Okay. Then next, 1 on 1. Q0 on 1. Q0, Q4. Q1 on 1, Q2. Okay. One next, 1. Okay. Now Q0 on 1, Q0, Q4. Next Q4 1, Q5. Q2 1, abort. No transition. Means end. This is end. Then next 0. Q0 0. Again Q0, Q4. Q4 0. This is abort again. Q4 0, no transition, no? This is abort. Next Q5 0, Q5 only. Okay. All the input symbols are over. 0, 1, 1, 0. Now where you are after completion of one is at Q naught, another one is at Q4. These are the three states, three possible states: Q naught, Q4, and Q5. Are you getting? So, but this Q5 is final state, na? Q5 is one of the final state. Final state. So accept. Accept the string. Okay. Why this is going to be accepted by Q5? Because of having a substring 1 1. Having a substring 1 1. Are you getting now?
Yes, sir.
No. Actually, this is a machine. No, this machine. How many states are there? Q. Q naught. Q one. Q two.
Six is.
Q three. Q four. Q five. This is Q naught. Right. What is sigma? Final states 2 3 2 5. Initial state delta dash transition function okay. Now we can construct a table for this. First, you note down this. We have to construct a table for this. This is a NFA computation tree to test a language belong a sentence belongs to language or not. So in this way, this NFA can work. It can generate a tree. Okay, it can generate a tree diagram. You can note down this. Now we have to construct a transition table that I we can. So I'm removing this part. Yeah. Now I'm going to construct a table, delta dash. How many input symbols? 0 1. Initially Q naught. Q naught on zero. Where you are going? Q naught on zero.
Q naught or Q1?
Q naught, comma, Q1. Right? Q naught on one. Q naught on one.
Q naught, comma.
Q naught on one. Q naught, Q4. Next. Q1. Q1 on zero. Five. Q1 on one. Q2. Q2 on 0, Q3, Q2 on 1, Q3 on 0,
Q3,
Q3, Q3 on 1, Q4. Okay, note down. Over.
Yes.
So this language accepted by this is machine. NFA is a machine with 5 tuples. We have defined all the tuples now. In a previous slide. And you find all the tuples, 4 tuples. Now this is the 5th tuple, delta dash. So these are the 5 tuples. And this is also, we can say, a machine M, language accepted by this machine is equal to X belongs to 01 star such that X has substring either 010 or 11. Okay. Now discuss another model, another language. Okay. Discuss another language. you tell me, I will give the model Q naught initial state, any 0 or 1 here itself. On 1, it is moving to Q1 state. On 0, 1, Q2 state. On 0, 1, Q3 state. On 0, 1, Q4 state. And this is the final state. From here, there is no transitions. Think about what is the language? What is the language? Of course, this is a machine. This is NFA. This is not a DFA. Why this is not a DFA? From Q naught, only one transition is there. And from Q naught on one, two transition, two states it is moving. One is at Q naught and another one is at Q1. Because of these reasons, this is not a DFA. This is a NFA. NFA is also machine, of course. Okay. So that is also language. Now, what is this? Of course, this is a language sigma 1 star, 0 1 star, because input symbols are 0 1. Can you tell me what is the language here?
Sir, 1 followed by 000 or 111.
Now, this is the fourth bit now. This is fourth bit now. This is the last final state means this is the first bit from the right side. Okay. First, second, third, this is fourth. So, first three bits right side, from right side, three bits could be either 0 or 1, but fourth bit could be 1. Fourth bit should be is 1. Then the remaining bits, any, either 0 or 1. Either 0 or 1. So this NFA will accept the strings from the right side, fourth bit is 1. Yesterday, I told the model for this. How many states required in the yesterday's? Yesterday, we have discussed. We have constructed a deterministic finite automata for right side and left side. For right side, fourth bit, how many states are required?
2 to the power 4.
2 to the power of 4, because yesterday we have discussed a model, deterministic finite automata model, for third bit is right side, third bit is 1. How many states we have taken every time? We have to maintain the three last three symbols. For that, how many states required? For that, how many states? 8 states are required. Yeah. Now here, this model, this model can recognize the strings language. Fourth bit is 1. So how many states? 2 to the power of 4 states are required. But NFA requires how many states? Only 5 states are required. DFA requires how many states? 2 to the power of 4. 16 states are required. Okay. So the same language, but it can be accepted by DFA as well as NFA. NFA takes less number of states than DFA. Right. So the strings, now here X, the fourth bit. From right side, fourth bit from right side, is 1. Okay. So you can state that also. DFA requires how many states? DFA takes how many states? 2 to the power of 4. But NFA takes only 5 states. NFA takes only 5 states. You take a string 0, 1, 0, 0, 1. So fourth bit is 1. This is accepted, no? This string.
Yes, sir.
Fourth bit, right side fourth bit. Now let us see how this model will work. That model, Q naught. 0. Q naught on 0. Where it is going? Q naught only, na? Q naught on 0, Q only Q naught, na?
Yes, sir.
1. 1, Q not 1, Q not 1,
Q1, go to Q1,
Q not and Q1, both. Okay. If any mistake, you tell me. Huh? Then next symbol, 0. This Q not 0, Q not 0, Q not. Q1 0, Q2. Okay, next 0. Q not 0, Q not 0, Q not Q1. Q2 0, Q3. Okay. 0, 1, 0, 0, over. Next 1. Last one. Q not 1. Again, Q not 1. Q not Q1, na? Q not?
Yes, sir.
Q not Q1. Q1, 1. Q2. Q3, 1. Q4. Okay, now the entire string is over. What are the states? Q naught, either you are at Q naught, are you at Q1, are at Q2, or Q4. So this is accept, na? Final state, na? This is one of the final states. So that's why it is accept. Okay. Now this is accept string. For example, you take this one. You can construct a computation tree. This is fourth bit is 0, na? So this is reject. You can compute a computation tree like this. You can find out. You can find out a computation tree. You can find out a computation tree and show it on your copy. Who is absent today? Nobody? Just now one joined.